Mobile gathering speed, about to turn the corner. Mobile swings into the straight, getting down now towards the starting point. Blue light is flashing, they're off and running in the two-year-old, and down near the inside, Kinstar Lass began well. Racing fast for the lead, though, and getting a triple agent from the Comedian. They were followed by Rosemont Tradition, Balakira Rebel. Just a lady four deep from Kinstar Lass, Prince Lobel, Triple LG for Colburn Fury. And last of all now in the event was Top Hat and Tails. A bit of a scrimmage passing the 600, and they commence the run down the back where the leader now was triple agent from Rosemont Tradition, the Comedian, the rail out. Four deep was Just the Lady. They were followed by Prince Lobel, Triple LG in behind them, Kinstar Lass in advance of Balakira Rebel, Top Hats and Tails, and for Colburn Fury brought up the rear. They leave the back now and move to the corner. A lap and a quarter left before them, and Triple Agent the leader, three parts of a length to Just the Lady. Down on the rail with nowhere to go to Comedian, followed then by Rosemont Tradition, Triple LG. Top Hat and Tails is going fast right around the outside, tacking onto it for Colburn Fury. Kinstar Lass was next to last, and Balakira Rebel brought up the rear. So running down for the bell lap and 750 to go, and still the leader in the event was Triple Agent from Just the Lady. Top Hat and Tails, the Comedian, Rosemont Tradition, Triple LG for Colburn Fury, three deep in advance of Prince Low, Bell, Kinstar Lass, and still last of all was Balakira Rebel, 600 to go, and Triple Agent was still in charge over Just the Lady. The Comedian, one still going well, was Top Hat and Tails, taking on to it for Colburn Fury. They were followed then by Rosemont Tradition, Triple LG. In behind those, Prince Lobel from Kinstar Lass and Balakira Rebel. They leave the back and move to the turn, 350 out. And the leader in the event now was Top Hat and Tails, two lengths to the good of Triple Agent. The Comedian off the rail and commencing a forward move out deep to Colburn Fury, followed then by Triple LG, Just the Lady, Kinstar Lass and also Prince Lobel, but around the corner. And Top Hat and Tails was nicely clear over the Comedian. Here's one battling home well, Triple LG, and for Colburn Fury, and right up the top of the track was Prince Lobel, but Top Hat and Tails still good, beat Triple LG close for third. For Colburn Fury or the Comedian, followed by Kinstar Lass, Balakira Rebel, Rosemont Tradition, Just a Lady, and the one of the last home in the event would be Prince Lobel.
Righto, 10-7 and a photo, race 8 at Maitland, 10-7 and a photo. Let's take you to Terry now for the next coming through from Brisbane Odds On, this favourite number four.
Seas of Blue at 10 to 9 on the Queensland TAB, $1.90. Paparelli and Romeo's Fortune finding their spots on the outside of the line. Unextended goes up. Joy's Romeo, Seas of Blue, Sovereign Venture, Bag of Tricks and You Next come in. Will he fly? Ken Girard on the second line. Light is on. Racing and You Next came out of the gate very quickly. Joy's Romeo began well. Unextended fast away. But You Next outpaces them going to the first turn, and he's the leader on the bend out of the straight. You Next is in front by a length over Unextended. Joy's Romeo third. Sovereign Venture moving up three deep around Bag of Tricks, and on the rail came Will He Fly. Two lengths to Ken Girard, one to Paparelli. Romeo's Fortune second last, and the favourite Caesar Blue drops out to the rear. You Next a length clear past the tea trees at the 1700 metres mark. Sovereign Venture races up to second in the breeze. Joy's Romeo a length away third. Unextended fourth, one out, one back, and then Will He Fly on the inside of Bag of Tricks, a length to Paparelli, one to Ken Girard in the running lane from Romeo's Fortune, and Caesar Blue last at the 1400 metres peg. Lead time 36.8, and You Next leads by a length and a quarter. Sovereign Venture second, Joy's Romeo third, one to Unextended on the outside of Will He Fly, Bag of Tricks three back in the running lane. Paparelli awkwardly placed on the fence, then Ken Girard, Romeo's Fortune, and still Caesar Blue at the tail as they round the bend for the bell. They're at the 1100. You Next keen to go faster by one to Sovereign Venture. Joy's Romeo third locked up on the back of the speed. Unextended fourth around Will He Fly, and then Bag of Tricks, Paparelli, Ken Girard, Joy's Romeo, and Caesar Blue last in the best part of 10 from the leader. 32, first quarter of the mile. Little change in the order as they turn out of the straight. You Next has been in front every step of the way. He leads by more than a length over Sovereign Venture at his wheel. Joy's Romeo a neck away third, Unextended fourth on the outside of Will He Fly, then Bag of Tricks, Paparelli, Ken Girard, Romeo's Fortune, and Caesar Blue's got a big job to do. 30.9 second quarter. You Next, one in front at the 550. Unextended leaves the sweet seat, goes after the leader. Sovereign Venture spits out the bit. Joy's Romeo on the rail needs luck. From Willie Fly, Bag of Tricks, Paparelli, Ken Girard, Romeo's Fortune, and Caesar Blue still last at the 300. You Next a half in front. Unextended closing the gap. Joy's Romeo on the rail and Willie flies after them now. Then Sovereign Venture and Caesar Blue would have to be Cardigan Bay. You Next leads when they turn, not for long. Unextended grabbed him, but Willie Fly grabbed them both. Willie Fly hit the lead from Unextended. Joy's Romeo and Romeo's Fortune running on, particularly Romeo's Fortune. Oh, he almost fell. Willie Fly's won. Willie Fly from Unextended. I think Romeo's Fortune third, and I think he was going to get him, but he almost hit the deck. Joy's Romeo's in the photo for third from Sovereign Venture, Caesar Blue. Then Bag of Tricks, Kent Girard, You Next and Paparelli.
Right. 13 in a photo. Race 6 at Albion Park. Side of the boxes in Sydney for race number 8, the Superfecta. Here's Rod.
And racing, beginning well in the middle was Top Egyptian, joined the outside by Little Bill and also Don't Call. Hustling up in the middle was Farmer Wilson, Jagman Prater Deep, Tudor My Joe Lass, followed by Mascalero, and last was Young Whipper down the back. And soon after, Little Bill has raced away. Little Bill by two on second, Top Egyptian, the fence, Farmer Wilson, followed by Don't Call, Prater Wide, Jagman checked around it. On the fence was Mascalero from Young Whipper, but they've let Little Bill get right away in the straight. Little Bill straightens five in front, Don't Call to second, but it's all Little Bill. Little Bill first, second, Don't Call third, Mascalero, followed by Young Whipper, Farmer Wilson, My Joe Lass and Jagman. Last of all was Top Egyptian.
Righto, 617835 across the line. That's how we've picked the Superfecta. And hopefully those numbers will be correct. Not that we've got it, but I'm just telling you in case you have. Race 6 at Globe Derby, Fiddler's Star at 12s. Number 2, Tokelo is at 40-1. And easing even further to 80s now, number 2. Number 3, Rainbow Rocket is at 80-1. Number 4 is at 14-1. Number 5 is at 9-1, which is Tabinaday. Number 6, Poshak, showing at 20s. Number 7 is at 5-1. 11-2 for number 7. 11-2 for Helen's Pleasure. Number 8, Mike's Choice, currently showing odds on. 2's on. Stylish Adios is at 18-1 for race 6 at Globe Derby. And the selection there for you from Pete Smith. Pete has suggested each way Mike's Choice, Tabinaday and Fiddler's Star. Albion Park placings 13, 7 and 9. Moonee Valley Dividends, Multi-Strike 1082, 2120, Almeadow Man, Marquita Expo 280, Quinella 780, Trifecta 239.30, Pair of Fives in the DD 52 even, the Quad Extra 3,231.10. Maitland Dividends, placings in Sydney by the way, 6, 1 and 7. Top Hat and Tails 260, 140, 680, Triple LG, Percolvin Fury 170, Quinella 7750, Trifecta 274.90, Race 8 at Maitland. And that's the story there. Well, they've gone 60 metres at Wentworth Park. We had the Superfecta, Rod, but that changed pretty quickly.
Well, if you did have the Superfecta, Nick, well, it's your shout. But Little Bill has just run them off their legs. They jam behind. Don't Call got a checkered passage. Poor Farmer Wilson in bad bother, just out of the straight and towards the back. And what looked like being a two-dog race, that's not normally the way it turns out when it looks that way on paper, because Little Bill has made a mess of them. Paying $19.90 for the win and $3 for the place. One Don't Call at $1.30. Seven Mascalero, $2.90. The Super
26.45 the journey. Bourne Road free for all, they're away. Now Rainbow Rocket began pretty well, but so too did Fiddler's Star on the inside. Tokelo in the centre and out. Four wide going to the first turn to Binaday. Helen's Pleasure is trying to drive up behind the leader. In the centre there, Mike's Choice away pretty well. Easing back to the tail, Poshak in front of it are the two stablemates, and they are springing bear in front of Stylish Adios. Into the back the first time, and Fiddler's Star has held the inside running. To Binaday's working overtime to try and get around Helen's Pleasure. Now she got off the rails there and at the moment is going to have the trail on the back of Tabinaday, but Tabinaday is going to go on with it and it's going to look for the lead. Now Helen's Pleasure could drop to the rails if she wished. 5 or 6 metres into Tokelo. Mike's Choice next on the outside. On its back in turn then was Springing Bear, dropping to the inside, Stylish Adios. Poshak second last, and having to ease back to the tail, Rainbow Rocket. Into the straight they come this time, 2 1/4 laps left to run, and Tabinaday, after working, has got to the front and steadies them, led 4 metres on the rails. Fiddler's Star. Now Helen's Pleasure is caught facing the breeze, and 1 by 1 Mike's Choice. Tokolo 3 back the inside, on the back of Mike's Choice is Springing Bear, the inside Stylish Adios, 3 metres then to Poshak, and 4 metres to Rainbow Rocket. Lead time quite reasonable at 1:19.2, and Tabinaday, the leader by 4 metres. Now Mike's Choice isn't sitting for much longer, in fact here he comes. Mike's Choice takes off 3 wide to go around Helen's Pleasure. Fiddler's Star behind the leader, next along on the outside, Springing Bear, Tokolo the rails, 4 metres to Poshak, the inside in turn then was Stylish Adios, and Rainbow Rocket whipped them in. They're about to leave the back straight, they've got a lap and a half left to run, and Tabinaday the pilot, led by 1 metre, in second placing up on the outside, Mike's Choice keeping the leader honest. Helen's Pleasure now with the trail 1-1. Fiddler's Star's had the run behind the leader for quite a way now. Next along then to Springing Bear, midfield, Tokolo and its inner, 4 metres Poshak, Stylish Adios held up on the inside, and still Rainbow Rocket whipped them in. This middle section hasn't been all that quick for this class. Tabinaday, the leader by 2 metres. Mike's Choice on the outside. The leader's still going pretty well. In behind them, Fiddler's Star travelling all right. On the outside, Helen's Pleasure. Then Tokolo. It's outside then off Springing, or I should say outside of it was Springing Bear. Still well out of it, Poshak, Stylish Adios, Rainbow Rocket. No real moves coming as they make their way towards the back straight with 600 to run. Now the quarters were 31.8 and 30.8, and now Mike's Choice is applying the pressure to Tabinaday, and he got 1 metre, now 2 metres clear. Helen's Pleasure is tracking Mike's Choice. Fiddler Star looks to get clear. Springing Bear trying to come deeper. Poshak off the track from Stylish Adios, the centre. Tokolo drops out, and then Rainbow Rocket, but Mike's Choice is broken away. Helen's Pleasure running second, but she's under pressure. Then Springing Bear, Tabinaday look beaten. Fiddler Star still only half into the clear, and Stylish Adios from Poshak, but into the straight, Mike's Choice nicely clear. Helen's Pleasure can't get him. A Springing Bear hanging on to third. Rainbow Rocket flashing home, but Mike's Choice scores. 4 metres Helen's Pleasure. 6 metres away, third home was Springing Bear in front of a line of four. Fiddler's Star, Stylish Adios, also Poshak and Rainbow Rocket. Tabinaday knocked up at the finish, and Tokolo last in. Far too good the favourite. Mike's Choice, driven a confident race by Lance Justice, put him into a position where he could do as he wished, and he has been too solid for 7 Helen's Pleasure, and third placing in the race will go to number 4 Springing Bear. So the numbers here are 8, 7 and 4. They've run a good time for the 2600 metres. They went pretty quick that first lap, eased up a little in the second, although the sectional still weren't too bad. I'd say they've sprinted home the last half pretty quickly, but the overall is 3:20 and the mile rate is 2:1.7. So 2:1.7 is a very good run over the 2600. Second placing, or the winner I should say, Mike's Choice, owned by Alan Turner, a bay gelding 5 by Tudor Hanover, out of Frost Bar, trained and driven by Lance Justice. 7 Helen's Pleasure is by Royal Rabbit, out of Brandy Miss, trained by Ken Dim, driven by Peter Holberton. Good effort from her tonight, she's done some work early. And then 4 Springing Bear by Russian Bear from Spring Hills Fleur, trained by John Justice, driven by Lisa Justice. Mike's Choice pays 75 and 70. Helen's Pleasure returns 75 cents for your 50 cent unit. And 4 Springing Bear to pay $1.15. They are all provisional at this point. After the running of race number 6 here, the other details are not with us. In fact, here they come. Now, the sectional times. Now, they went 1:19 and a bit for the lead time. Then they've run 31.8. 30.8, 29.3 and 28.9. So the last mile, they've run the first half 62.6, the last half in 58.2, and it's 3.5 metres by 5. We do have all clear right to pay. The all clear is there after the 6th.
Right. Now, let's have a look and see what else we have for you. We have the Moonee Valley 7th race market to bring you. Number 1, Friendship at 25s, Nankita is at 30s. Number 3, Chiola's Lass is showing at 2s on. Number 4, number 4.
Ready, Eastern Lena will miss the start by 100 metres. Ready, green light comes up and away they go. Sure Glory out wide has come out in a full stretch gallop. Chiola's Lass away quickly with on the outside Galaxy Girl, who's looking for the lead, and now Galaxy Girl heads off Chiola's Lass. Countess Cordavis on the outside gets to third, followed by Friendship fourth. 4 metres away on the outside is Donabella, followed by Nankita. 8 metres away, Sectair, working up on the outside is Scotch Dundee. Eastern Lena won't settle down, and out the back is Sure Glory. Around the turn in the first circuit, the leader is Galaxy Girl by 8 metres, Chiola's Lass. She's content to take the trail behind the leader, and making ground the outside is Countess Cordobes, followed by Friendship on the rail. 4 metres to Donabella. In behind them came Nankita. A break of 12 metres to Sectair. Up on the outside is Scotch Dundee. 50 metres away, Sure Glory. And 20 metres away, Eastern Lena. At the judge, the first time, two circuits out. And the leader is Galaxy Girl by 5 metres. Chiola's Lass on the leader's back. Half carting for a stride out of the straight. In behind them came Friendship on the inside. Third, the outside is Countess Cordobes, followed by Donabella on the outside, then Nankita. 8 metres away, Scotch Dundee. Back on the rail is Sectair. Some 50 metres to Sure Glory, and 12 metres away, Eastern Lena. Along the back at the 1400, and the leader is Galaxy Girl. From the outset, she's had a handy break. She's 8 metres clear of Chiola's Lass, having a nice run. 8 metres away, third, Countess Cordobes, followed by Donabella, now without cover. Then Friendship on the rail, fifth. 5 metres to Nankita, Sectair the outside, followed by Scotch Dundee, and the two out the back, 35 metres away, Sure Glory, and 20 metres to Eastern Lena. Approaching the turn in the Victoria Trotters Oaks at the 1150, and Galaxy Girl, she's been bowling along from the outset by 6 metres to Chiola's Lass. Countess Cordobes 5 metres away, third, then Donabella, fourth, fifth on the rail is Friendship, 4 metres to Nankita, 8 metres away, Sectair, followed by Scotch Dundee, 15 or 20 metres away, Sure Glory, and 80 metres away, Eastern Lena. Out of the straight, they travel towards the back at the 850. Galaxy Girl still in control by 5 metres. Chiola's Lass.
Let's have a look at the up.
Have a Gay Fox driving up along set. They're racing. Good even line out. Winning the break was Aaron Champ over Gay Fox driving up along the fence. Third American Sun followed by Cinemore Fox. All one checked out of play was Single Lord. On the inside was Spinster's Hut. And back towards the tail was Sir Frederick together with Short Siesta. And five last was Single Lord. Down the back it's Aaron Champ by a length. On second, Gay Fox there. Five clear from Amerigo Sun third. Next, Spinster's Hut followed by Short Siesta and Cinemore Fox. In the straight, Aaron Champ and Gay Fox go together. Aaron Champ pulling out Plenty Gay. Gay Fox lunging, they hit the line. Gay Fox in a photo. Gay Fox over Aaron Champ. Photo third, Spinster's Hut or Short Siesta, followed by Cinemore Fox, American Sun, Single Lord just in front of those. Photo finish after the ninth event. Gay Fox has lunged at Aaron Champ. And it's very, very close.
Down towards the starting point they come for the running of race nine. Blue light flashing, a good even start, and down near the inside, Show Silk and racing hard for the lead. Mont Royal followed then by Inform, Peggy Who, Millie Scott. Gary's Notion was followed then by Darajan, Blazing Mountain, Hall Pack and Paleface Power. Down past the 600 where Darajan put in the bad one, and the leader in the event was Mont Royal, Inform going out after it. Next was Show Silk, followed by Gary's Notion on the inside of Peggy Who. A couple away to Millie Scott, Blazing Mountain down on the rail in advance of Darajan, Paleface Power, and Hall Pack brought up the rear. They leave the back and move to the turn. A lap and a quarter left before them, and they're going along at a fairly fast clip. We're in form, the leader, over Mont Royal, a couple away to Show Silk. They were followed then by Peggy Who on the outside of Gary's Notion. In behind them, Millie Scott from Blazing Mountain. Darajan was next. Paleface Power was second last, and Hall Pack brought up the rear. Around the corner and down to the judge with the bell lap coming up this time, and no change in the order. Where Inform was doing it well in front, maintained a lead of a length and a half over Mont Royal. Show Silk was next from Gary Notion, Peggy Who, Millie Scott. Over on the rail was Blazing Mountain, followed by Darajan, Paleface Power, and Hall Pack brought up the rear. 600 out at Inform by a length to Mont Royal. Show Silk was next from Gary's Notion without cover. They were followed by Millie Scott. Out deep on the track was Peggy Who in advance of Blazing Mountain, Darajan, Paleface Power, and still Hall Pack was last of all.
all 400 to travel, and in form making every post a winner a length to Mont Royal. Show Silk was next from Gary Notion, Millie Scott, Darren Jernan winding a big run around the outside of Peggy Hugh, and still last of all was Hall Pack, about 250 left to travel, and in form was the leader from Mont Royal, Show Silk, Millie Scott, Darren Jernan was next, and Gary's Notion is gone, and Peggy Hugh last to the main division, but in form in front, Mont Royal, and now Show Silk right down the centre. It's in form in front over Mont Royal and Show Silk, and in form beat Show Silk. Mont Royal next from Billy Scott, Darren Jan Hall Pack, Peggy Who. In behind those was Gary's Notion, Paleface Power, and Blazing Mountain last in.
Thank you, Ned. Now the moving up race 7, Albion Park. 214, Maitland race 9. Here's the start now coming up for the Diet Fanta Stakes. Race 7 are all starting.
Velvet Blue just about ready to run. Lights on, racing. Pavelito out wide, came out quickly. Wipe off began well. Colonial Flame on the rail, and then Watt Pro Footman, followed by Dirty Diana and Velvet Blue Chip in front of Chasing Success. Albie Bowen second last, and Foreseeable Future dropped out to the tail. Pavelito crossed onto the rail and led at the 1300 metres mark. Colonial Flame second, Wipe Off a half away third, and Watt Pro Footman settles fourth. Two to Dirty Diana, a length and a half to Chasing Success, one to Velvet Blue Chip. Foreseeable Future second last, sliding up on the rail, and LB Bowen whipped them in down the stretch the first time. 29 for the first quarter of the mile. Pavelito's the pilot at the judge in the red lights, by two to Colonial Flame and two to Wipe Off. A length away, Watt Pro Footman, who was going up deep as Wipe Off moved away from the fence again. Watt Pro Footman latches onto the back of Wipe Off. Chasing Success on the fence, and then Dirty Diana right behind Watt Pro Footman. Foreseeable Future on the rail, two to Velvet Blue Chip, and LB Bowen last with short of 800 to travel. Pavelito takes them to the back, 31.3 second section, and Pavelito leads by two over Colonial Flame. Two to Wipe Off on the outside of Chasing Success, and Dirty Diana's going forward now. She's three deep around Watt Pro Footman and Foreseeable Future on the fence. One to Velvet Blue Chip and a neck to LB Bowen. Pavelito giving them something to catch at the 450, leading by a length over Colonial Flame, who's off the rail to give chase. Chasing Success a length away third, then Wipe Off, Dirty Diana three deep, Foreseeable Future on the rail, followed by Watt Pro Footman, Velvet Blue Chip, and LV Bowen. Pavelito clear on the bend, 200 to run. Pavelito one to Colonial Flame, who's under the bat, then Chasing Success. They're clear of Dirty Diana. Pavelito leads with 100 to go. Colonial Flame flat as a tack, and Pavelito kicked away again. Pavelito's led from go to one. Pavelito first, Colonial Flame second, Chasing Success third, then Wipe Off, Foreseeable Future, Dirty Diana, Watt Pro Footman, Velvet Blue Chip, and LB Bowen. The driver of Colonial Flame had a little trouble with his whip halfway down the straight. It may have become tangled up with the horse's tail, but it made no difference at all.
G'day, my name's Gary Ward and I manage Bartlett's Club Tavern in downtown Rockhampton. Next time you're in central Queensland or passing through, come in and say hello. This is the hotel where the sportsmen drink. We've got the cheapest beer in town, we've got the biggest raffles. Come and have a beer by one of our swimming pools and grab some specials from our drive-in bottle shop. But if you're a member of the Lions Club or Apex Club and you're heading through central Queensland, call in and say hello. There's always a cold beer on the bar for you, and this is their hotel. But the Bartlett's Club Tavern, corner of Denham and Kent Street, it's the only place in Rockhampton to have a beer.
Flash at 20s for race 10 at Wentworth Park. Almost set at Globe. Here's Pete.
They're set here and they're away and racing at the 22.30. Venturian began okay. Oscar is driven out from the start. He's looking for the lead. The favourite Oscar gets 2 metres clear as the turn comes up, and Venturian can't hold Oscar, so it's Oscar working to the lead from Venturian. Fold and Command three wide round that first turn, works around Jammeroo Park. Magic Merchant three back, the rails on settling. 4 metres further back in the field into Baker Street. Maasai Warrior is going to settle a long way back, as was Milmag. Copped a slight check there, Mil Mac, and back to the tail was Have a Star. Well, the favourite leads as they race down to the judge with two to run. It's Oscar by 4 metres in second, placing on the inside Venturian. Caught facing the breeze now, Fold and Command. Three back the inside, Magic Merchant, Jamaroo Park 1-1. Lead time 47 seconds. Then we've got Baker Street, one off the rails. In fact, the last five are all racing one off. That's starting up with Jamaroo Park. Then on its back, Baker Street. On its back, Maasai Warrior. In turn, Mil Mac. And last, Have a Star. Racing into the back. Lap and three quarters out, and the leader, Oscar, clear by 4 metres. Venturian the inside, Fold and Command the outside. Jamaroo Park's now moved around Magic Merchant in the 1-1 Jamaroo Park, that is. 4 metres to Baker Street. Still racing solo one off. Maasai Warrior on its back. Another 4 metres then to Mil Mac, and whipping them in, Have a Star. Halfway around the top turn, a little over a lap and a quarter left to run. And still the pilot was the favourite, Oscar. It travels nicely. They only went 33.2 for the first quarter, so they haven't gone quickly. Oscar led, 4 metres, Fold and Command, Venturi in the rails. Jamaroo Park's nice and handy. Then Magic Merchant needing some luck. Baker Street on the outside from Maasai Warrior. Mil Mac takes off three wide at the bell, and Have a Star trying to follow Mil Mac. Heading towards the back straight outside door, just under the 800 to run. And the leader was Oscar by 3 metres in second, placing on the outside, Fold and Command. In behind them, Venturian, second quarter, 31.3. So they sped up. Jamaroo Park next on the outside. Hasn't come out on it yet, although now Mil Mac moves around. So Jamaroo Park pushes Mil Mac four wide. Baker Street following Jamaroo Park. Magic Merchant waiting for an inside run. Have a Star push very wide, and Maasai Warrior now last off the back, and Oscar's trying to go for home. It got about 6 metres clear on Jamaroo Park and Venturian. Still no run for Magic Merchant. Fold and Command gone. Baker Street was working into it. Mil Mac wide out, and then Have a Star. They turn. Oscar's got a useful break. It led 5 metres from Venturian. Jamaroo Park. Now Baker Street and Mil Mac are starting to power home. Oscar, no good thing. Jamaroo Park and Baker Street go to it. Magic Merchant gets up on the inside. Jamaroo Park does best. And Jamaroo Park gets up and beats Baker Street. Tight for third. Might go to Mil Mac from Oscar or Magic Merchant. Have a Star's close up out wide from Venturian, not far away. And the last couple, Maasai Warrior, and with it, Fold and Command. Jamaroo Park will be the winner. The visitor. Well, the stablemate went very well earlier in the night. And this has gone very well.
Set. They're racing. Beginning well was Jessica Bale, and also Crystal Blue from outside River Flash. Charging up along the fence, Jessica Bale has it at the first turn by a length and a half on Zola's Image. Two third was Crystal Blue. Three further back to River Flash, and two and a half, Red Ridge Darcy is the field strings. Right out for Miss Hannah. Second last, Short Allen. Last of all, Sunshine Lass. Out of the straight, Jessica Bale's on the bunny. Five lengths in front of second, Zola's Image. Two lengths third was Crystal Blue. Followed by River Flash on the inside. Making some ground was Miss Hannah. Behind those came Red Ridge Darcy, followed by Sunshine Lass. Five last tailed off was Short Al. To the home turn, Jessica Bale's in front. Finishing on was Zola's Image there. Five clear from Crystal Blue. Jessica Bale is holding Zola's Image as they get near the line, and Jessica Bale wins well. Jessica Bale versus Zola's Image second. Sunshine Lass flew to get third, followed by Miss Hannah and Red Ridge Darcy from Crystal Blue, River Flash, and last of all, whacked towards the rear of the field was Short Al.
All right, Rob, we'll have what we call a delayed replay with you in a moment. A replay, I guess, is delayed, really, in a lot of ways. Now, race out at Mooney Valley. Number one coin is at 8-1. 30s for number two, Eyes of Jade. Number three, Social Lass, at 30s. 4-1 for number four, Out of. Five, Kira Sun.
Filly Snakes, green light comes up and away they go, out at it is showing speed, next door Kira Sun is away very quickly, and this big lump of a filly now ambled to an early lead, Kira Sun in front. Alert Girl from the outside now travels into second placing and drops in behind the leader. Coin settles down third, out at it now fourth, in behind them Eyes of Jade on the outside of Stairway to Heaven. 6 metres away Savit, back in behind them came Motoring Empress. On the fence is, as they race out of the straight, third last Soaky's Fling. 4 metres away, Karamia BB, and dropping out to last is Social Lass. They're starting to shuffle up down the back towards the 1500. Coin now third, angles one off the fence. It draws up to the leader's wheel, and in front is Kira Sun. Alert Girl third. Eyes of Jade is fourth on the outside with a head to the side. Back in behind them, Out of Debt. 4 metres away, Savet the outside, followed by Stairway to Heaven. Motoring Empress back in behind them. 6 or 8 metres away, Soakie's Fling. Second last on the outside is Karamia BB, and Social Lass is last. Approaching the turn, they've almost gone the first lap, and the leader is Kira Sun by 2.5 metres. Coin on the outside draws up a little bit closer. Alert Girls at a nice run behind the leader. Then Eyes of Jade on the outside. Back in behind them came Out of Debt. Savet always handy. 3 back on the outside of Stairway to Heaven. 3 metres away, Motoring Empress. In behind them came Soakie's Fling. Second last, Karamia BB. And last on the fence is Social Lass. Out of the straight, they race towards the 800. Still Kira Sun in control. She's had a good run this